Soda Fork Creek is located 20 miles east of Sweet Home, Oregon, as a tributary to the South Sanium River. It is part of an important watershed for salmon and has the potential to provide habitat for threatened species such as winter steelhead and Chinook salmon. So why don't fish spawn in these waters? While Soda Fork Creek may appear a healthy, beautiful stream to the casual observer, hydrologists and fish biologists know it is lacking a key component, large downed wood.
Well, Soda Fork was scoured down to bedrock because of past practices where they came in and they logged out there's big cedar logs that were in this, and it retained all the gravel, and now it's all gone.
To replace the missing wood that once trapped the gravel and created spawning beds, the Forest Service and the South Sanium Watershed Council developed the Soda Fork Creek Restoration Project. Stream experts carefully selected trees based on size and location. They planned each tree's placement in order to create a stable and complex logjam. Trees were not cut, but rather pulled over in order to keep the root wad attached. Keeping the root wad intact will protect the structure from high flood events, which would otherwise push the wood downstream. Experienced contractors were hired to use cable and heavy machinery to topple the trees.
And each structure that we put in, of all those eight structures or whatever there are, should be one that's clear down on the bottom, engaging the stream, and then more multiple pieces on top of that so that the wood will engage the stream at all different flow levels.
In the end, 34 trees were added to the Soda Fork Creek. The amount of wood placed in the stream was based on historical data and is intended to replicate natural log jams. While it may look messy to the human eye, it mimics what should have been here all along.
In this particular case, the logs in the stream will be able to trap the gravel that the fish need to spawn. They also trap leaf litter that then becomes the base of the food chain, right? The bugs eat the leaves and then the fish eat the bugs. It restores the stream. And so everything that has evolved with the stream in these conditions has evolved with wood in the streams as well, right? So it's part of the whole ecosystem to have wood in the streams. And probably there's a lot of reasons that we don't even understand why it's important for it to be that way, but that's the way it is naturally. And so that's the way we're trying to make it again.
With the help of a nearby high school, hydrologists will monitor the creek's changes over the next several years. The students are measuring stream width, recording location and number of pools and riffles, and using photo points to track the changes.
We're hoping to see a lot more gravel throughout this whole reach and a lot more pools, and so spawning gravel areas and pools, but we'll see in 5 years. Hopefully we'll see hundreds of steelhead spawning. That'd be cool.